Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is multiplying decimals, part one, and we do the following problems on this video. We could multiply decimals by writing the decimals as fractions first, and then we could multiply the fractions, and then write our answer in decimal form. So here's an example. What if I had 0.3 times 0.4? Well, what does this mean? What does 0.3 really mean? It means 3/10. In fact, that's how we should actually read it, times 4/10. Now, I know this can reduce, but to understand the multiplication of decimals, we're not going to reduce. This would give us 12 over 100. And now that could be written in decimal form again, because that means 12 would be in the hundredths place, so we would have 0.12. So here's what's important to notice is my actual multiplication, if you look at the top in the numerator, ended up just being the 3 times 4. And that's the idea. You just ignore the decimals and multiply. Okay, so that's the first thing we're going to do. We're just going to look at this and say, okay, what's 3 times 4? Well, that's 12. And then we're going to see how many places total we have digits after the decimal point. We have one there and one here. We have two total places after the decimal point. We've got to make sure our answer has the same number of total places. Put decimal so that it has same total number of places. As the original numbers. Okay, let's try another one. So let's say we had 0.11, which means 11 hundredths, right? Times, and the reason I'm using the times symbol here is I don't want you to get it confused with it, with a decimal point. Times, let's do 2.3. Okay. So if I want, I could change these to fractions. And just to illustrate the point, I'm going to do that again here. This means 11 hundredths, right? Times 23/10. Remember, if there's, you could just write the number 23, and then there's only one decimal point, it's in tenths. So I could do 11 times 23. That's 253. You could get out a piece of paper and do that, or if you know the trick for multiplying by 11s, with the two-digit numbers, you can do that in your head, and that's over 1,000. And then I could rewrite that as a decimal. Since I'm dividing by 1,000, remember I have to bring the decimal in three places. And of course, I could put a zero in front of that decimal point. Okay, so let's do it the shortcut way. The shortcut way is I just think 11 times 23, right? Okay, so that's 253. And then I count all the digits that are after the decimal point. So you're counting up the total number of digits and all the numbers after the decimal point. There's three, so I have to make sure wherever I put my decimal, there's going to be a total of three. All right. Here's one for you to try. Right. So you're going to do 2/10 times 3/10. A lot of people think you have to get out a piece of paper to do this, but once you know the trick, you can do that in your head. What is 2 times 3? 6. How many places, how many digits are after all the decimal points? 2 total. So my answer has to have two digits after as well. So 0.06 or 6 hundredths. If you had changed this to fractions, you would have gotten the same answer. 2/10 times 3/10 equals 6 hundredths, and then written your answer like this. So the trick is to multiply the two numbers as if there are no decimals to begin with, and then just count the number of places. So let's say you had this problem, 234, I'm sorry, 2.34 times 1.6. All right, now that I can't do in my head. So the idea is we simply multiply 234 times 16. So however you want to do that, I'm going to do it the old-fashioned way. So that's 24, carry the 2, that's 20, carry the 2, 12, 13, 14. And then we've got 4, 3, and 2. I have 3, 7, 4, 4. So notice I don't even have any decimal points in here. What you could do is fill in the decimal points as they re where they really were right now. So it was really 2.34, and this is really 1.6. And so how many digits are there total after the decimal points? I've got 1, 2, 3 total, so my answer needs to have three places at the end. Now, notice this is very different than addition and subtraction, where you line up your decimal points. You do not line up your decimal points necessarily. I mean, they might end up being lined up, but you don't need to line them up. For instance, look at this next problem. If I have 2.5 times 1.6, well, I just think 25 times 16 and do that problem. So let's see, that's I think 150 and 25. I get 400. And it so happens it really was 2.5 and 1.6. A lot of times I think it's easier to put the decimal points later because it confuses people. And so the answer here, notice, would be 4.00. It's just the number 4. That just equals 4. Because I have two total digits after the decimal point. All right, so in this case, what I wanted to you to note, it so happened that the decimal points lined up, but that had nothing to do with the problem, the fact that they lined up. Okay? They don't line up necessarily. It's just that you're multiplying 25 times 16. That's really what you're doing, and then you have to decide where the decimal is going to go. So let's do this one, multiply. Now, sometimes it's given to you in this form. All right, so they've already kind of placed it, and you'll notice it didn't matter that the decimal points lined up. And so what you have to do is when you're multiplying, just ignore those decimal points and do the regular multiplication. So we have 4 times 2 is 8, 4 times 0 is 0, 4 times 4 is 16, 5 times 2 is 10, that's going to be here, and 4 times 5 is 20. So I have 21708. And now we just again count how many digits total are there after the decimal point. And there's 1, 2, 3. So our answer will have three digits after the decimal point as well. So we have the answer to this is 21.708, which of course, what does that mean? 21 and 708 thousandths, right? Well, let's estimate this. 4.02, that's like 4, right? Times, well, a little bit bigger than 5 because it's 5.4. 4 times 5 is 20. So the same, our answer seems in the ballpark. It's a little bigger than 20. It's 21 point something. So when you're done, you should kind of look and see, does it seem reasonable about where your decimal point is given what the whole numbers were in the first place? So the whole number parts were just 4 times 5. So our answer should be more than 4.4 times 5. All right, let's say you had this problem. Multiply 0.046 times 100. Right, now the easy way here is anytime you multiply something by a power of 10, you get a just, which means 10 or 100 or 1,000, you just get to move the decimal to the right, that number of digits that there are zeros. So when I multiply by 100, I get to just move this decimal 2 to the right. So the answer is 4.6. So that's the quicker way of doing it when you're multiplying by 10 or 100 or 1,000. Let's try another one. Right, so multiply this number by 1,000. Try that. So what will that be? You just get to move the decimal 3 to the right. 8654.3. So don't bother doing this. This is kind of, I see people do this. I don't know why. They go times 1,000 and they're just writing all these zeros like this, et cetera. A bunch of rows of zeros. Don't need to do that. No. Unnecessary. If you're just multiplying by 1,000 or 100 or 10, you just get to move the decimal over the right number of places. Let's see if we can do this one on our head. We have multiply 1.2 times 300. All right, so let's do the thing where we just ignore the decimal point. So I have 12. That's how you want to think of that. 12 times 300. But to do 12 times 300, really, all you do first is just do 12 times 3. So first we do 12 times 3, which would be 36. And then you just add on those two little zeros because it was really 300. So just like with the 100, you get to move the decimal 2 to the right. Here you just get to add zeros. And now you say how many, let's go back to this, how many digits were after the decimal point? Well, there was only one, and so now we go back here and move the decimal in one. So my answer is 360. Let's try another one like that. Okay, so we've got multiply 0.008 times 40. So all you have to do is think of what's 8 times 40. And to do 8 times 40, first just do 8 times 4, which is 32. But add the 0 because it was really 40, not just 4. So I do 8 times 4, add that 0. Now I go back and I say how many places are supposed to be after the decimal point? 3. So it comes back here, back in. So there's 3 places after the decimal point. So my answer is just 0.32. Or 32 hundredths. So once you know these little tricks for multiplying with decimals, and when you have like all these extra zeros, you don't have to do, long multiplication anymore. Right, so that's really all there is to multiplying with decimals. You simply multiply, and then you have to make sure that your final answer has the right number of digits after the decimal point based on the original two numbers. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos which are organized by topic.